I'm here with newly elected Mayor, Mr. Mike Taylor. Mayor Taylor, why did you want to become mayor of New Philadelphia?
That's really a good question. That's something I thought about for a long time. I feel that my background in real estate, banking, and law enforcement gave me a really good background to be a mayor. Things that I deal with in the city involve those areas, safety issues, people's homes, money, tax dollars that we work with. I was the treasurer for the last 5 years in the city, so I have been around the city for 5 years. Although that was a part-time position, I still came to know and understand how the city worked and operated. I know most of the employees and was encouraged by a lot of employees to run for mayor. They thought I would do a good job and they would be interested in working under my leadership. And that's what happened.
So what kind of things are you going to bring to New Philadelphia?
Well, the first thing that we have to do as a new mayor is you have to come in and you have to learn the job a little bit. Even though I was in the building for 5 years, I was downstairs. And let me tell you, it's different being a part-time treasurer as opposed to being a full-time mayor. So although the mayor was upstairs, not having done the job, I really didn't know what it involved on a daily basis. But what I want to work on is I want to continue a couple things that were in the hopper from the prior administration. We need to really focus on getting the high-tech park down near Kent State developed. We need to focus on getting some businesses in there, some new companies to come to New Philadelphia and bring us jobs, which create income tax dollars for us. The CIC is the owner of the high-tech park, and it's their primary responsibility to market that, but the city is certainly willing and wants to participate in that because we will be direct beneficiaries of those new companies and those new jobs. That's one of the things that's on our plate. We have already went through our budget process for this year. It's on the council committee agenda. We've had our hearings and the budget will be presented to council for final approval. The give and take, the little tugging back and forth on budget issues are done at the budget hearing, so I've got that under my belt. We are 2 weeks ahead of what we did last year. It's worked pretty smooth this year, so I'm happy about that. And the last thing I'm working on, or we got done, is our health insurance for our city employees. We participate in that. It's a very expensive proposition, and we've worked on our renewal premium, and we've got that behind us, and we know what we're going to have to pay for the next year. We pay over $1 million a year in cost for health insurance for our employees. That's what the employees pay as their portion plus what the city pays. So it's a very large expense of the city, and that's something we need to focus on really early in the year, and we have done.
So what's your first month been like?
My first month has been a whirlwind. The administrative assistant who works for me also worked for the prior mayor for 8 years, and she informed me about halfway through the first month that she has never seen it this busy in January, and I said, lucky me. But we've had a lot of things going on. I mentioned the budget process to you. I mentioned the health insurance. Those were big things on my plate. When a new mayor comes in, everybody wants to come in and say hello and meet the mayor. Even employees, they want to say hi. And it takes quite a bit of time because nobody's ever just 1 or 2 minutes. They want to sit down and pretty soon 20 or 30 minutes has gone by. So it eats into your day, but it's certainly something that I wanted to participate in and do early on. I want the employees to feel like they can come and speak with me, that I have an open door and that I will listen to them.
Earlier I learned that you have another business. Can you tell me a little about that?
I'd be happy to. It's my hobby and I'm in the antique business. And I've been down at Riverfront Antique Mall for 3 years as a dealer. I have a couple booths down there, and my primary interest is furniture, old furniture. And I like to buy it. Usually I find it at auctions. Last year when I was working part-time, I went to about 95 auctions last year, so that's quite a few. And I spend a lot of time, but I pick up furniture if I can buy it at a good price, and sometimes I have to rehab it or clean it up and restore it, sometimes repair it a little bit. But I've taken a lot of dirty pieces of furniture that were covered with dirt and made them look pretty nice and have sold them because they are old through the antique mall. But that's a hobby of mine. I really enjoy it. I miss the time that I was able to devote to it before because I don't have that kind of time now. But I'm finding that with my weekend auctions and sometimes in the evening, I still am able to keep my booth at the antique mall and keep it as a hobby because it's something that I really enjoy.
Well, thanks for talking to me today.
T- Taylor, it was nice to meet you. Good luck to you and your new little career here of doing interviews. I understand I'm your first one. You did a great job. And it's been a pleasure, and I hope the people that view this know a little bit more about me and a little bit more about the mayor's job. Thank you.
I've been talking with Mayor Mike Taylor, and I am Taylor Ross for QTV News.